Do. It's really you!
That's me.
There's a snake in my boot.
To infinity and beyond!
Today, we are learning English with Toy Story. We're going to look at a couple iconic scenes from the second movie. And if you want to keep learning with the best movies and TV series so that you can finally understand fast-speaking natives without getting lost, without missing the jokes, and without subtitles, then just click on the subscribe button and the bell down below. Like our community member, Nora, who says that she is amazed that thanks to our channel, now she can understand more than 70% of movies when she watches them.
In the film, Woody is stolen by Al, a toy collector. This makes Buzz Lightyear and his friends embark on an adventure to rescue him. But Woody is then tempted by the idea of immortality in a Japanese museum. At Al's apartment, Woody meets Jesse, Bullseye, and Stinky Pete, and learns he is based on the main character of a 1950s television show called Woody's Roundup. Al has collected an entire room full of Roundup relics, but lacked a rare Woody doll.
What?
Whoa! Oh, hey, stop! Horsey, stop! Stop, Sid Boy! Stop it! Yeah! Sid, I said! Whoa! Whoa!
Yay! It's you! It's you! It's you! It's you! It's you! It's really you!
That's me. Stop saying that.
Prospector said someday you'd come. Sweet mother of Abraham Lincoln, the prospector, he'll want to meet you. Say hello to the prospector.
It's a box.
He's mint in the box. Never been opened.
Turn me around, Bullseye, so I can see. Why, the prodigal son has returned.
Yeah! It's you! You're here! It's you!
Okay, I'm officially freaked out now.
Oh, we've waited countless years for this day. It's good to see you, Woody.
Listen, I don't know what... Hey, how do you know my name?
Everyone knows your name, Woody.
We usually add Y or IE with some nouns in order to make them sound more affectionate or endearing. For example, for cat, we say kitty. For dog, we say doggy. And for bird, we say birdie. Let's go over some examples.
Here, kitty, kitty, kitty.
Girls, this is Kyle, my dog.
Fluffy doggy.
What?
This can also happen with names. For example, James, Jimmy, Margaret, Maggie.
Okay, class, optical orbits up front. And remember, we keep our supersophageal ganglion to ourselves. That means you, Jimmy.
Oh, man.
At that time, I had no idea Maggie even existed.
Dad!
Hi, Maggie.
Stop, Sid Boy! Stop it!
Sit, as an imperative, is a common command given to animals, mostly dogs. Example, we're trying to teach our dog to sit. The next common terms are related to cowboys, so you could commonly hear them when watching a Western film, for example.
Whoa!
The interjection whoa is generally used as a command that you give to a horse to go faster, jump, slow down, or stop.
Whoa, 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 boy! Easy. Easy.
Yeehaw is used as an expression of enthusiasm or excitement.
Yeehaw! Ride him, cowboy! Woo!
He's back? Hey, everybody! Andy's back!
It's really you!
What's me?
There's a snake in my boot!
Ha! It is you!
Please stop saying that!
Prospector said someday you'd come!
The word prospector is related to the verb to prospect, which means to search for gold, oil, or other valuable substances on or under the surface of the earth. We can also refer to a prospector as a digger, lander, miner.
Just as I suspected. Prospecting without the authorized equipment. Don't move a muscle.
Prospecting.
Now, you got your shovel, pickaxe, Benadryl, loofah, sorted snacks, some puzzle books.
Sweet Mother of Abraham Lincoln!
Here, Jesse plays around with the expression Sweet Mother of Jesus, or Sweet Mother of God, which is used to express surprise, disappointment, or even anger. However, people tend to avoid using expressions containing the words God or Jesus in order to sound less offensive. For example, in a children's movie like Toy Story. Check out this example.
Mother of Jefferson Davis.
It's beautiful.
Milo, I gotta hand it to you.
The prospector! He'll wanna meet ya!
This is an interesting sentence to analyze in terms of connected speech. Let's start with a contracted form of he will that sounds like the word heel, this part of the foot. I notice many learners make the mistake of saying heel as he will. Make sure that you don't do this when you see the contracted form because it can make you sound robotic. If you want more tips like this, then after you finish this lesson, check out this video with Andrea on our Real Life English channel where she will show you how to speak faster. The want plus to connection in native speech is so frequent that you can even spell it like wanna in informal conversations. And finally, for meet ya, we see that when T plus Y connects, we usually have a ch sound, as in cheers, and the reduction of you to ya. Again, the you reduction is also very common in native speech, so in casual conversations, you can also spell it like ya. Make sure that you say it like ya, not yeah or ya. Give it a try.
He'll wanna meet ya!
The more wrinkly your brain gets, the more he'll wanna eat it!
Nice to meet you.
And do you get frustrated when natives speak fast like this and you can't understand? Do you feel lost and confused if you don't have the subtitles? Now, it's not important that you speak this way, but mastering connected speech like this is absolutely crucial if you want to confidently understand native speakers. And this is exactly why in our Fluent with Friends course, we will help you to learn the principles of connected speech so that you can understand natives at any speed. The best part? You can try it absolutely free with our 3-part masterclass. Just click here or in the description down below to join that now.
Say hello to the prospector!
It's a box.
He's mint in the box!
Jesse is referring to an expression commonly used by collectors. If something is in mint condition, it is perfect, unused. So mint in box or mint in sealed box refer to the practice of keeping toys or other collectibles in their packaging even after purchasing them.
Oh, that's great. Let's open them up and put them in there.
Oh, no, good Lord, no.
Why, they're just toys.
But they're mint in box.
Come on, can't we open one up and take a look?
Turn me around, Bullseye, so I can see. Why, the prodigal son has returned.
The expression, the prodigal son, is used in reference to someone who leaves home and does a lot of things that people do not approve of, but still receives a very friendly welcome when they return home. Take a look at this example.
My son is home!
Son returns. This is perfect!
I thought you hated Zuba.
Okay, I'm officially freaked out now.
We use officially when we recognize that something is now true.
The street rat is living in the palace now? Ah, that does it! All reports are in! Life is now officially unfair! Wait a second!
If someone freaks out, they may experience different emotional states, such as those of fear, anger, or excitement, which is Jesse's case.
Please don't freak out.
I'm not freaking out. Are you freaking out? No, I'm just very interested in your hair and the magical qualities that it possesses. How long has it been doing that exactly?
Oh, we've waited countless years for this day. It's good to see you, Woody.
Listen, I don't know what...
Countless is another way of saying very many, especially more than you think is reasonable.
I don't blame you. I've terrorized the city countless times. I created a hero who's turned out to be a villain.
The toys find Woody, but Woody refuses to go home. Buzz reminds Woody that a toy's true purpose is to be played with, which he would never experience in a museum. Woody realizes Buzz is right, and asks the Roundup gang to come home with him and the other toys. Jesse and Bullseye agree, but Pete obstructs them, revealing he was actually responsible for preventing Woody's earlier escape attempt. Nobody has ever played with Stinky Pete before. He still is in his original packaging and is determined to go to the museum.
Hey, you guys, come with me.
What?
Andy will play with all of us. I know it.
Woody, I don't know.
Wouldn't you give anything just to have one more day with Emily? Come on, Jesse. This is what it's all about. To make a child happy. And you know it. Bullseye, are you with me? Okay. Good boy. Prospector, how about you?
Prospector?
You're out of your box.
I tried reasoning with you, Woody, but you keep forcing me to take extreme measures.
Wait a minute. You turned on the TV last night, not Jesse.
Look, we have an eternity to spend together in the museum. Let's not start off by pointing fingers, shall we?
You really are Stinky Pete, aren't you?
Prospector, this isn't fair.
Fair? I'll tell you what's not fair. Spending a lifetime on a dime store shelf watching every other toy be sold. Well, finally my waiting has paid off, and no hand-me-down cowboy doll is gonna mess it up for me now.
Hey, you guys, come with me.
What?
Andy will play with all of us. I know it.
Woody, I don't know.
Wouldn't you give anything just to have one more day with Emily?
If you say you would give anything for something or to do something, you would pay, give, or do whatever is necessary or required to acquire or achieve a thing for which you have an intense desire. Check out this example.
He writes the books. He is the keeper of all fairy knowledge.
That's perfect. Is he here? I have to talk to him.
I would give anything to talk to him. But you can't.
Come on, Jesse. This is what it's all about. To make a child happy. And you know it. Bullseye, are you with me?
Woody's horse has an interesting name that is also related to the Western theme. On a target like this one, the bullseye is the center. If you hit a bullseye in archery or shooting, then you hit the target perfectly. If you say that you are with someone, it means that you support or agree with them.
Woody once risked his life to save me. I couldn't call myself his friend if I weren't willing to do the same. So who's with me?
Okay, good boy. Prospector, how about you?
Prospector?
You're out of your box.
I tried reasoning with you, Woody.
If you try to reason with someone, you try to persuade them to do or accept something by using rational arguments.
Well,
Well, a bonfire won't stop Maleficent.
Of course not. But what will?
Well, perhaps if we reason with her.
Reason with Maleficent?
You keep forcing me to take extreme measures.
If you have to take extreme or drastic measures in order to solve a problem, you do something that seems beyond what would be considered normal or acceptable.
I've already missed tea, Mr. Albatross. Now don't force me to take drastic measures. You must relax.
Relax? I have never been more relaxed in my life!
Wait a minute. You turned on the TV last night, not Jesse.
Look, we have an eternity to spend together in the museum. Let's not start off by pointing fingers, shall we?
The phrasal verb to start off means to begin. Take a look at the example.
So, is everything ready for tonight?
Oh yeah, I thought we'd start off with soup and a light salad, and then see how we feel after that.
If you point the finger at someone, you accuse them of being responsible for something bad that has happened. In other words, you blame them or say that it is their fault.
You saying this is my fault?
Well, if the rose fits.
Let's not point fingers. It's Serena's fault.
Guys. Right! What about her?
You really are Stinky Pete, aren't you?
Prospector, this isn't fair!
If you say that something isn't fair, it is not reasonable or morally right.
I know why you did.
Well, I guess this is goodbye.
Oh, that stupid law. This isn't fair. I love you.
Fair? I'll tell you what's not fair. Spending a lifetime on a dime store shelf watching every other toy be sold.
If you refer to a store as a dime store, it sells a variety of cheap products. Alternatively, you can say 5 and dime and 10 cent store. Nowadays, with inflation, this will more likely be called a dollar store.
Where'd you get your clothes? 5 and dime store?
Well, finally my waiting has paid off.
If you do something that pays off, it brings you some benefits. Take a look at this example.
Yes!
Your training has paid off.
Oh, Master Shifu.
Gotta go. See you later.
And no hand-me-down cowboy doll is gonna mess it up for me now.
The phrasal verb to hand something down means to give clothes, toys, etc. to someone when their previous owner no longer needs them. Example: this wooden car was handed down to me by my grandfather. In the scene, the prospector is using this phrasal verb as an adjective to emphasize that Woody is a secondhand toy, as opposed to him, who is intact in his box. This phrasal verb can also be used as a noun to refer to the objects that were passed on from another person. Check out this example.
Hey there, sport!
Oh, hi.
These are your 12-year-old parts. They're...
hand-me-downs. I know, Dad. I don't mind.
They are from your cousin... Veronica.
And no hand-me-down cowboy doll is gonna mess it up for me now!
If you mess something up, you ruin it, make a mistake, or do it badly.
When we messed up our homeland, set sail for the sky.
It's common to describe situations that are not going well as messed up.
Dad, we had a deal!
I know, we did, but that was before I... it's all so messed up.
So everything in the ring, a trick? What? Whoa!
No! Hey, stop! Horsey, stop! Stop, Sid Boy! Stop it! Sid, I said! Whoa!
It's really you!
What's me?
There's a snake in my boot!
Ha! It is you!
Please stop saying that!
Prospector said someday you'd come! Sweet mother of Abraham Lincoln! The prospector! He'll wanna meet ya! Say hello to the prospector!
It's a box.
He's mint in the box. Never been opened.
Turn me around, Bullseye, so I can see. Why, the prodigal son has returned.
Yeah! It's you! It's you! You're here! It's you! It's you! It's you!
Okay, I'm officially freaked out now.
Which picture represents someone who is not freaking out?
Oh, we've waited countless years for this day. It's good to see you, Woody.
Listen, I don't know what... Hey, how do you know my name?
Everyone knows your name, Woody.
Hey, you guys, come with me.
What?
Andy will play with all of us. I know it.
Woody, I don't know.
Wouldn't you give anything just to have one more day with Emily? Come on, Jesse. This is what it's all about. To make a child happy. And you know it. Bullseye, are you with me? Okay. Good boy. Prospector, how about you?
Prospector?
You're out of your box.
What do you hear? Your altar box? You out of box? You're out of your box.
Tried reasoning with you, Woody, but you keep forcing me to take extreme measures.
Wait a minute. You turned on the TV last night, not Jesse.
Look, we have an eternity to spend together in the museum. Let's not start off by pointing fingers, shall we?
You really are Stinky Pete, aren't you?
Prospector, this isn't fair.
Fair? I'll tell you what's not fair. Spending a lifetime on a dime store shelf, watching every other toy be sold. Well, finally my waiting has paid off.
Here, the prospector means his waiting has given him some benefits. He got money after waiting for a long time. He had to pay to be waiting in a box.
And no hand-me-down cowboy doll is gonna mess it up for me now.
I hope that you enjoyed learning with Toy Story 2 today. If you can't get enough of lessons with your favorite TV series, movies, and songs, then make sure that you follow us over on our Instagram, because we make new lessons there every single day. Next, I would recommend that you learn English with this lesson from the first Toy Story movie. Let's check out a clip from that.
Everybody hear me? Up on the shelf, can you hear me? Great. Okay, first item today. Has everyone picked a moving buddy?
What? Moving buddy? You can't be serious.
Well, I didn't know we were supposed to have one already.
We have to hold hands.
Oh, yeah, you guys think this is a big joke. We've only got 1 week left before the move. I don't want any toys left behind. A moving buddy. If you don't have one, get one. All right, next.